good morning, good evening, good afternoon, and as you know, it better not be good night. Here we are again with HFLE for all the week. And you know, this is an initiative of the Barbados Association of Guidance Counselors. And with us today, we have
Kim Jones. Hi, Ms. Jones. I'm the guidance counselor of Combermere School. Up and on, everybody. Up and on.
Up and on. And you know, I'm Donna Telcox, the counselor at Graydon Seeley Secondary School. Now, today we are talking about a very interesting topic, one that a lot of people in the community are always talking about, and that is conflict resolution.
Yes.
Right. So let's first start off with what exactly is conflict? What exactly is conflict? Let's discuss that briefly. Kim?
Yes.
Let's share. What's conflict?
So conflict is when you have a struggle. There's a struggle going on, whether it's with yourself. So it's a struggle between two opposing forces. So one person wants something and the other person wants something else. Or in your mind, you're thinking, I should do something, I shouldn't do something, I should go this place, I shouldn't go this place, and you're unsure of which direction to go in. Whenever we think of conflict, a lot of times we always think about the outside, so a person fighting on with another person. But your conflict can be internal. What do I do in a certain situation? One part of me is saying I should do this, another part is telling me I should do that. That is also conflict as well. So never see it as just external. It can be also internal.
That is so true. And I especially like that internal part of the conflict because lots of times we know the correct thing to do. But sometimes we may have friends who are telling us to do something else. Or sometimes just I'll give you an example. I'm supposed to get up early on mornings to exercise. Kim, you can understand this.
Yes.
All right. My alarm goes off, the sun is up, I stretch, and a part of me says, okay, you know you have to get up, and the other part of me says, man, lie down in bed.
It's just a few more
minutes. And then you can go tomorrow, right?
Yes.
So that's internal conflict.
That's right.
But then, if I do get up, and I do get out to exercise. And I'm sitting in the class, and then there's some people saying, okay, let's do the dumbbells. We're gonna exercise with the dumbbells. There may only be two dumbbells, and there are five people that want to do dumbbells all at the same time. Yeah. So now we're also fighting for, and I say that nicely, we want the same resources.
Yes.
So sometimes conflict also arises if there are less resources
Yes.
than what everybody could use.
Yes.
Okay? And I'm sure you could think of a lot of things like that right now happening.
Yes.
Right where you are, where there's not enough of something that all of you may want. That, too, creates conflict.
Absolutely. You could also have a situation where there's so much of everything that... I'll give a simple example. We've all heard of Black Friday sales, where you have things that would be $400 dropped to $99 or $79. And we have seen the videos and the newscasts where people are fighting over TVs and over clothes and over toys because the prices are so good that everybody wants the best sale. That's a classic example of having a whole bunch of resources that everybody wants and everybody wants the same thing and are willing to get into a conflict just to see if they can get it, whether it's good or bad.
Exactly, exactly. So these are some really interesting examples of conflict. I want to show one last example, and everybody has this at their house. I know it for a fact. We all have bathrooms with toilet paper, correct?
Yes.
Right. Now, when you put the toilet paper roll, the new toilet paper roll, back onto the spindle, what direction do you put it? Do you put it where the paper comes over the top? Or the paper gets pulled from the bottom. Exactly. Now you can have one house, okay, but different ideas about how one thing can be done. So some people get upset when they go into the bathroom and see when they pull the toilet paper, it's coming over the top. And others will get upset when they see the toilet paper pulled and coming from the bottom.
Yes.
So that in itself is another way of having conflict. You have an idea, and your idea is different to somebody else's idea for the same thing.
Absolutely.
Right? Now, with all of these different examples of conflict, what do you think? Is conflict good? or is conflict bad? Let's start. Again, Kim, what's your take? Is conflict good or is conflict bad?
Conflict can be good and it can be bad. That's an interesting question. I think that conflict can be good if something positive comes out of it, and it can be bad if your reaction is negative. Conflict can cause us sometimes to grow, where we see something is wrong in a relationship, or what we thought was right really is not as right as we thought it should be, and we learn to change and we learn to grow. So conflict sometimes is a wake-up call. Think of it like a splash of ice water in your face that lets you go, wait a minute, this is not working, this is not the way it should be, let me fix it. Now, it can be bad if, because of the conflict, a fight breaks out and you're harming yourself, or you're harming someone else, or you are being negative in your outlook and how you deal with people. So really, the conflict of itself is not a bad thing. Your reaction determines whether it is good conflict or bad conflict.
I wholeheartedly agree, because when we look at even conflict on a large scale, sometimes we will sit in Little Barbados and wonder, what are they fighting for? What's all they're fighting about? And sometimes we would think that you know, if they actually came together and discussed how they could share some resources, and a lot of the time it's about resources. If you share resources, you could better deal with that aspect of the conflict and make it something that's positive.
That's right.
Where everybody can learn how to get along and get some things that they all need, as opposed to fighting, which most of the time ends up in trouble. On one of the better scales, a bad fight could just get you into trouble with your parents, with your teachers, maybe even with the police, where you get a warning or you get removed from the situation for a while. But on the worst case scenario, it could end up in loss of life.
That is true.
And we've seen so much of that recently that it's mind-boggling, all right? But the thing about conflict is this. As Kim said, it's neither good nor bad. Mm-hmm. It all is a determination of how you deal with it. So we're going to look first now at some ways that conflict is expressed. What are some of the indicators or some of the little signs that we're in conflict? Something right here, right? So one of the things that I'm going to start off with is the whole aspect of silence.
Yes.
Sometimes when there's conflict, you go, I'm going to shut my mouth. I'm not going to be talking to that person because they have me upset. Mm-hmm. And I'm upset because of this thing here. Yes. Either they want what I want, they've gotten to it before I got to it, so I'm going to let them know that I am upset by not talking to them. So sometimes silence.
Yes.
And the way you do your silence, sometimes in Barbados especially, we have the cut eye or the roll eye.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
We have the head. Well, in North America, you have a lot of the head going around like this. Or you have the looking away. You have a lot of gestures sometimes that would indicate that there's a conflict, right? Go away. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes people will show you parts of their anatomy that, you know, resemble cuss words, right? And they'll tell you stuff like that. And even babies have a way of showing that they're angry at you. Yeah. They will, when they're crying, they scream, and they would slap your hands away when you're trying to get close to them. Mm-hmm. So these are different little ways that you can show that there is conflict. But there's so many other ways as well. Yeah. So Kim, you can share some of those with us as well.
Well, the ones that we know very well are the physical. And when I remember gestures, I remember the fact that we as Bajans and Caribbean people, we're very expressive with our hands.
Very.
So we start, you would. Furthermore, if you even think that, we like to do a lot of that when we're getting pretty heated in a conflict. Mm-hmm. But it can get physical. And unfortunately, sometimes the physical is not always physical with fists. Mm-hmm. It can go to physical with rock, knife, gun, and that takes it to a whole different level.
But not meant to interrupt you here. You know, even before it just gets to that stage where it's so physical, the invasion of personal space.
Absolutely.
You get up in somebody's face. Yes.
I don't like that.
You know? And then it brings on other problems.
Yes.
Like, you talk about somebody's breath. And then that could, and that could really make escalate the conflict.
True.
But you were talking about the use of weapons.
Yes, that is the scary part, because a lot of times when it gets to that point, unfortunately, it gets to a point where there's no coming back from. Mm-hmm. When it gets to that stage, because somebody can get hurt, or God forbid, somebody can be killed.
Exactly.
And that takes it to a whole different stratosphere. It's a whole different ball game, and we have to be so careful. Again, as we said earlier, the conflict is not the issue. The issue is when there is conflict,
how do you deal with it?
What do you do?
And there's another part of conflict. Remember we spoke in the beginning about the internal conflict.
Yes.
And sometimes internal conflict is shown by you not being able to make a decision about what you want to do.
Mm-hmm.
And you end up doing absolutely nothing. That's called apathy.
Yes.
Right? Apathy. And that's another word for you. Apathy. A-P-A-T-H-Y. And with apathy, what happens is you are so undecided that you sit down or lie down and do absolutely
nothing.
All right? So these are some different indicators of conflict and of how conflict is maybe expressed. Mm-hmm. How do you know that there's conflict? But now that we know that there's conflict, we understand what it is, we see some indicators of it, what do we do to resolve it? Now, that is the key issue here. Mm-hmm. How do we resolve conflict? And notice the word is resolve, mm-hmm. because we are looking at how we are going to smooth it out, calm it down, deal with it.
Yes.
How do we resolve conflict?
One of the biggest issues that I've seen with conflict is that nobody sometimes wants to listen.
Yeah.
Sometimes just taking a breath and listening to what the other person says. It might be that I misunderstood what you were saying, or I was so worried about something else that I didn't realize that I bumped into you and you know, got you angry. And before I got a chance to apologize, the whole situation blew up in our faces.
Yeah.
So a lot of times, just taking the time to listen and listen to the other person's point of view. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you got to sometimes even listen to yourself, because remember we said that conflict sometimes is internal and external. And sometimes you need to have a conversation with yourself and know that is not being crazy. Sometimes you need to sit down and say to yourself, you know what, this is what I want to do.
I said to myself,
if it is that I do this, what could happen? What are the consequences? Are the consequences good or bad? Can I deal with the consequences? Will my family be proud of the consequences? Sometimes you need to sit down and have that conversation with yourself. And that helps sometimes to alleviate the conflict.
That's true. The other thing is to actually understand the situation.
Mm-hmm.
As Kim was talking, she talked about, you know, you bumped into somebody. But really and truly, was the conflict bumping into the person? Was the conflict because you didn't get a chance to say sorry immediately? Was the conflict that when you bumped into them, they were already in pain, and you may have made their pain worse?
Worse.
What was the conflict? What's the situation? What's really going on? Once you try to find out what the real situation is, sometimes that by itself could help to smooth out the conflict.
That is right.
All right? And another thing about doing that is being assertive. Because if you do not exercise your ability to say, stop, listen, I'm sorry if I hurt you. I know I've made a mistake. But let's try to figure out what else is going on here, okay? As opposed to, I ain't doing nothing. What you hang at me for?
Mm-hmm.
No. You want to be assertive, but not aggressive. Being aggressive is going to add to the problem.
That's it. You know? We don't want to add to it. We also want to look beyond the incident. You know, the person that you got into a conflict with might be the person that the teacher puts in a group to work on a project.
Mm-hmm.
Now, how do you work with the person who you had a conflict with and you did not take the time to solve the conflict?
Right.
You know, these are very important things. I always say we do not know in life where we might go and where our friends might go. And the same person that you had a conflict with now and you kept it festering for a whole 5 years in school, that person might end up being your doctor. You might end up having to be their doctor in the future or something like that. You know, take the time to sit down and be humble enough to sometimes admit, you know what? I was wrong. And I always tell my students this sometimes. Sometimes you don't always have to be right to say I am sorry.
Yeah.
Sometimes just saying, you know what? This is not worth it. I apologize.
Yes.
This is, we've been friends for too long. We've been acquaintances for too long. This is not worth it. Mm-hmm. Let's just squash this and let's move on. Let's turn a new leaf. That's important.
And sometimes you may not even be the person's friend.
That's
because we don't have to like every single person that we see or that's in our class or even in our workspace. But we do have the right to be respectful to each and every one. All right? And sometimes agreeing to disagree.
Absolutely.
It's a wonderful way of squashing the conflict.
Correct.
You have your opinion, I have my opinion. Guess what? I'm not going to hold your opinion against you if you don't hold my opinion against me. All right? But you have to see, as Kim has said, see the bigger picture.
Yes.
It may be a whole lot more than just this one little disagreement we're having at this time. And with that, another very interesting thing to do is to learn how to take a time out.
Yes.
Okay? Take some time. You're not being a coward. You're not running away. Okay? There's nothing, that's cowardice about taking a time out. Step back. You need some time to think. And sometimes when you are heated, when you get all heated up and ready for this conflict you want to fight, you need to take some time and breathe and so breathe. That your brain can clear so you can understand the situation much better. Mm-hmm. So take a time out.
Yes.
All right?
I like that.
And another thing that we can look at too is once you all have decided, okay, we're going to try to see if we can find a solution to the problem, all right? Find out from the other person what they think will be a good way to solve this particular problem of conflict.
Yes, 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 yes.
You know?
You may not have all the answers. The person might have another way of dealing with it that you never thought about. The person might be able to sit down and explain, okay, this is why I thought this way, or this is why I, you know, why it came to a head. You might not be the one to have all the solutions. Sit down. Let's see if we can come to an agreement. And note what I said. Come to an agreement. Even if the agreement is we agree to disagree.
Exactly.
That is still an agreement.
Yes. And that's the last thing. Accept the agreement that has been made.
Yes.
Accept it. Now, we are fast running out of time. We always seem to be running out of time, don't we?
Yes, yes.
But we have a challenge for you, all right? There's going to be a picture up, and it's the challenge of the two donkeys. These two donkeys are tied together. And on either side, there is food for these donkeys to eat. But, as you can see from the picture, the donkeys cannot get to the food if they are struggling against each other. So they have to sit down and think about how they're going to eat. Your challenge is, what do you think the donkeys decided to do? Do you think the donkeys decided to starve in the middle? Or did they work out a way that they can both eat? Okay. Let's see if you and the donkeys are on the same page. Help the donkeys find a way to both eat. Mm-hmm. So when you do that, you can put it in the email. I do believe now we're having another email address that we can use. Mm-hmm. Apart from your guidance counselor at your school, you can send your emails to bagc@email.com. And you can just put in the subject, two donkeys. We would know what you're talking about. Or you can also put conflict resolution. But I think I like two donkeys.
Works. That works.
We agree with two donkeys,
that
right?
That works.
Okay.
Me.
So at this point in time, we'd like to tell you thank you for being with us again today. And Kim, you have any last 5 second words?
Agree to disagree is not a problem. agreeing to disagree is a good thing. Conflict is not a bad thing. How you react to conflict is what makes it good or what makes it bad. Let's do the good way to resolve the conflict.
Thank you, Kim. And for my two cents, I agree with Kim. So until next time, from HFLE for all of we, bye. Stay safe. See you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye.